Hi friends, welcome to the Jarvis Universe. Today I'm gonna tell you how to control LEDs using Arduino. So let's look at the components we need to make this happen. We need three LEDs. We have got red, blue and green LEDs and suitable resistors to protect LEDs from surges. So we are going to connect LEDs and resistors in this manner. The negative will go to the negative rail of the breadboard and positive will go to the resistors. As you can see, I have connected three wires from positive that will go to the digital terminal of the Mega2560 board, and negative terminal from the rail will go to the negative of the 2560. So I have connected negative rail to the ground of the Mega2560. So now it's time to connect positive terminals of the LEDs to the digital terminals of Mega2560. Now I will take the positive terminal of green LED and connect it to the digital pin 8 of the Mega2560. Similarly, I'm gonna take blue LED positive terminal and connect it to pin number 10 of the digital terminal of Mega2560. And same goes for the red LED. I'm gonna take the positive terminal and connect it to 12 of the Mega2560. After making connections with the jumper wires, we will switch to the programming with Arduino software and we will see how it works. So now my connections have been done. This is what Arduino software looks like. First, we have to define positive pins which are connected to the digital terminals of Mega2560. So I will write INT, that is used to define an integer. INT red LED is equal to 12. That means red LED terminal which is connected to the digital pin of Mega2560 is 12. Similarly, we will write for all three LEDs. Now we have void setup. In void setup, we set up inputs and outputs. It is only executed once. So we will set digital pins of the LED to output. Therefore, we will write pin mode red LED output. And don't forget to close every statement with a semicolon. We will copy this for each LED, red, blue and green, as you can see on your screen. Now as you can see, at the end of the statement, we can write comments for ourselves that for what this statement stand for. As I have written, define red LED as output, define blue LED as output, define green LED as output. This is the second section of the program where we write the program, which will be executed over and over again until stop. It's called void loop, in which we will write digital write red LED high. That means on digital pin we are writing LED to light up. High is the value which we write when we want our LED to glow. Now we will write a comment, red LED should turn on. Then we will write delay. Delay is the time for which LED will glow. Delay 2000 means it will light up for 2 seconds. Now similarly, we will write the program for turning off the LED, which will be as follows: digital write red LED low. Now we will write comment for turning off the LED and we will put the delay. Now we will copy this program and paste it 3 times as we have 3 LEDs. Now just we have to edit the defined integers. Now we will write for blue LED both for turning off and turning on. Similarly for green LED, both turning off and turning on. Delay will remain the same, 2000, and now we will edit the comments. Okay, after editing the comments, we will align the program. That is done by Control T on Windows and Command T on Mac. Now by clicking on this check arrow, we have to verify the program if there are any errors. First we have to save this file. Okay, so you can see there is an error in the program. It will be highlighted. Let's see what is the error. Okay, we forgot to put semicolon in the integer when we define the digital terminals. So as now we have put semicolons, you can see at the bottom the program is verified. Then under tools we have to select our board. Our board is Arduino Mega 2560. Then similarly, we have to check the port, the communication port of the computer, that you can also check in device manager. So now by clicking on the button next to the check arrow, we can upload our program. So after connecting your board to your computer, you can just press tap on it and you can see it says done uploading. Now you can see our LEDs has started glowing. LEDs are glowing in the sequence of our program: red, blue and green. As you can see, we have written this in void loop, so it will keep happening over and over again until you put a stop to it or you disconnect it. If you put a no repeat command, that we will discuss later, this program can be stopped after number of times. So we can make various changes to this program, like we can reduce the delay time. As it is 2 seconds right now, I will show you how to do it. So here we are back to the computer screen. Now we will reduce the time delay to 500, that is 0.5 seconds, half of a second. Once we are finished doing it, we can verify the program again and check at the bottom, okay, program verified. By clicking the upload button, we can program in the board. Whenever the program is uploading, these transmit and receive lights will blink. So as you can see, our program is uploaded. Now LEDs are glowing much faster than before because we have reduced the time delay. Now we can make various changes. We can change the sequence by changing the program. Now we will put all high together and low together so that all LEDs can glow one by one and then switch off one by one. So we are moving all the highs together and all the low together. As soon as we are done, we will verify and upload the program. Now we are done uploading the program. As you can see on the bottom, it says done uploading. Now we can move to the board and check how the program is working on the LEDs. So you can see red LED glows, then blue, then green, and it follows the similar sequence to turn it off: red, blue and green. So here we have, guys, we have learned how to control LEDs through Arduino. Please show your support by subscribing my channel and liking this video. Thank you. See you with the next lesson.